Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about functions and Dart. A function is a block of code that is executed only when it is called. So whenever you have something that you need to perform repeatedly, so in that case you can create a function that will perform that particular task, and whenever you need to perform that task you can call that function. Now let's see how we can create a function in Dart. So again, the syntax is very similar to other languages. The first thing that we write is the return type of the function. So the syntax is return type. Now return type is optional, but it is recommended to always define a return type for your function. Then we write the name of the function, and then we write parentheses. Inside parentheses, we can define parameters that are required for this function. For example, our function needs some input and then it processes the input. So in that case, if you need some input for your function, you can pass it inside the parentheses, same as you do in other languages. And then finally, we have a pair of curly braces, and this pair of curly braces defines the body of the function. And here you can write your code, or whatever you want to do, you can write it here. And your function can have a return value as well. So you can use the return keyword and you can return a value. Now, if you do not define a return statement for your function, the default return type is null. Now let's create an actual function. For example, I want to create a function that will count the number of words in a given string. So what I can do is I can create a function. The first thing that I need to write is the return type. Now return type is optional, so for now I am not writing the return type. So what I need is I need to define a function, and I will name it count words, and this function will take a string as the input. Now inside the function I can count the number of words inside the string. So what I can do is I can create an integer. So I have word count equals to s, and I will split the string, and I will split it by space. So I will get the list of words available inside the string. And finally, I will get the length from the list. And what I can do is I can return the length now. So I can write here return word count. Now, as you can see, I have not defined the return type for this function. Even then, I am returning word count. So if you don't define any return type, it is dynamic. And that is why it is recommended that you must define the return type when you are writing a function. But this will work still, so let's check this. And here I will write count or int count equals to count words, and I can pass anything. Let's say, hey, we are learning Dart. Now I will print count like this. If I run the code, I will get the output. And you can see we are getting 5. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And it is working absolutely fine. If I write count words here, then you can see the return type is dynamic. But as I told you, it is not recommended. And in this case, as we are returning a string, what I can do is I can write int here. Now this is the return type for this function. And now you can only return an integer from this count words function. So this is the basic syntax of a function in Dart. Now you can pass as many parameters as you need. And if you do not want to have a return value, then what you can do is you can write here void. Now void means this function do not have a return type. And now we do not have null as return value because it is returning void. And that is why we are getting error in this return statement, because this function returns void, that means nothing, and we are trying to return integer. So in this case, what I can do is I can simply print the count here like this. So if you do not want to return any value from your function, you can use void. Now this will also work, but as I told you already that you should have the return type while defining your functions, because it is the recommended way. So let's write void here, and this time I will just call count words and I will get the output because I am printing word count here. So I will delete this statement, and now let's run the code. You can see we are getting 5. Now if your function have only one statement or only one expression inside, then you can simplify your function. And in that case, what you can do is you can use this operator that we call arrow operator, or you can say it is an equals to and a greater than. And then what you can do is you can write as dot split and then length like this. So if you have only a single statement or expression, you can define your function like this. And I will change the return type to integer because I am returning this value here. Now this time I will get the value. So I will write int count equals to, and I need to put a semicolon here because it is important in Dart that I forget Kotlin practice. So we have the length and I have the count here, and I will print it here like this. So again, we are getting 5. So this is how you can create functions in Dart.